Good morning, my dear students of class 6, and I'm happy to welcome you all to today's botany class. What are we going to learn today? Our today's topic is about adaptations in desert plants. What did we learn in our previous class? We have studied about adaptations in grassland habitats. No, in a grassland, how all the plants and animals get adapted themselves to survive in a grassland, we have studied in our previous class. In today's class, we are going to learn about how the plants in the desert adapt themselves, what special features those plants have to survive in a desert. So let's get started. So before learning about the adaptations of desert plants, let us study some facts about what a desert is. Which place can you call as a desert, or what are the characteristic features of desert? Desert is a place which is usually dry. What does this mean? It is not wet. The soil in your garden all should be wet. No, either when you, because you pour water or because of rainfall, the soil surrounding us are all wet to some extent, but always the soil is dry in a desert. This is first quality. And then why it is dry? Because there is very little rainfall. Almost there is no rainfall in the desert at all. Very rarely there is rainfall. That's why the desert is a place which is so dry in nature, because of little rainfall. And also you must know that deserts are usually very hot, no? But the fact is, deserts are equally cold also. How hot it is, similarly, when during seasons, it is also cold to extreme conditions. And deserts are sandy, you know, usually in movies or in your Discovery Channel, all when you see deserts, you can find a sandy area, right? That's what that picture comes into our mind when we think about deserts. But equally, there are also rocks in deserts. How sandy it is, similarly, there are also rocks, or it is also rocky in desert habitats. So what are the few qualities we have seen in this slide? Deserts are dry in nature. Deserts usually have very little rainfall. It is hot, and also equally it is very cold. Deserts are sandy and also rocky. Let's learn few more properties of desert in the next slide too. Usually in deserts you can find dust storms. What is a storm? Storm is a very fast wind, no? That's what we imagine. Storms means along with rainfall we get speedy winds. That's what we imagine. But in deserts you can find dust storms. What is this dust storms? Instead of this wind or alone, along with the wind, what will happen? Dust and sand will be moving about very fast in the desert, and this is called as sand storms or dust storms. What does this mean? In deserts, along with the wind, you can find dust and sand moving about from one place to other in the air. So that is called as dust storms or sand storms. And also there is soil erosion. If you have soil because of storm, all known, usually there is no water flow. In geography you must have studied, no, about soil erosion. When you will get soil erosion? Usually when water keeps on flowing on one particular area, that area sand will get eroded. It will not be present after some time because it is washed away. That is erosion, right? But in deserts there is no rainfall at all. How it is washed away? Because of the wind. Suppose if there is a pile of soil in a desert in one place, the next day if you see, it will not be found. It will be eroded because of wind or the storm. There is frequent soil erosion in the deserts. And then there is marked difference between night and day. Usually in the day in a desert, if you see, it is very very hot. You cannot even put your feet on the sand, that hot it is. Marked difference or marked difference means extreme temperature difference. It is not slight difference here. Usually in our place all, if you see, we don't find much difference between the day and the night. No, almost 5 degree difference maximum you can find between the day and the night. But in the desert habitat, there is marked difference, which means there is a prominent difference between the temperatures of the day and temperatures of the night. How it is very cold during the nights, how hot it is during the day. The other extreme you can find in the night, it is very, very cold during the nights. Marked difference between the day and the night because you have colder nights in the deserts. Example for a desert is Thar Desert. Example you should know. Okay, so what we have studied in this slide, usually in deserts you can find dust storms, and also because of the storms there is soil erosion, and there is a marked difference between the day and the night because it is very hot during the day and extremely cold at nights. Example for desert is Thar Desert. So the properties or the qualities of a desert we have studied. What is the topic for today's class? It is the adaptations in desert plants. There are few plants surviving in the desert. Now can you see plants? This is cactus plant, right? So there are very few plants surviving in this desert, and the other plants cannot survive. You cannot plant all trees whatever you grow in your garden in a desert. Why? Because the desert plants have special adaptations in them that will help them to survive in a desert habitat. What are those adaptations, or what special qualities desert plants have to survive in this extreme hot and cold conditions? About that only we are going to learn in today's class. So the first adaptation in desert plants is they can conserve water. Usually if you have a rose plant at your garden, you have to water it at least for 2-3 days once. You have to water it frequently, otherwise what will happen? The plant will dry. No, but who is going to pour water to the plants in the desert? Also I already told you there is no rainfall, right? So how the plants will have water to survive? Because for longer duration, like 6 months once only you will have rain. So what will happen? How they survive? They conserve water. How smart they are, right? So conserve water means they store the water. Whenever water is available, they store them. Say they store and use them because they have succulent pods. What is succulent? Succulent means like juicy pods. The leaves of the desert plants are usually very thick. Cactus plants all commonly you must have seen, right? So when you try to break the stem of the cactus, you can find water oozing out, right? Because the water is stored in their stem. In their succulent plant parts will store the water or conserve the water whenever it is available and use it little by little. That is the adaptation of the desert plants. Example is cacti. Cacti means the cactus plant, which you know, I guess. And other examples are eucalyptus and agave. See, this is eucalyptus plant. You must not have seen these plants, so I have given the picture. So this is eucalyptus plant and this is agave plant. So what is the adaptation we have studied? The first adaptation, actually there are 4 adaptations given in your textbook. In 4 ways the desert plants adapt themselves. What is the first adaptation? Desert plants, to live in a desert, they save, store or conserve the water. Where do they conserve? In their succulent plant parts. In the stem, they usually, succulent plant part is the stem usually, okay. So they store or conserve the water in the stem, and 3 examples are given in your textbook, that is cacti, eucalyptus and agave plant. Clear? So this is the first adaptation. There are 3 more adaptations to study. Okay, let's see what is the next adaptation. The next adaptation in desert plants is about desert shrubs. See, I told you, because of very poor rainfall. Only very few grasses you can see usually in deserts, right? But very rarely you can see shrubs. Shrubs are a bit taller than the normal grasses, right? What makes them grow taller? Actually, these shrubs, no, they have a special adaptation, that is, they have deep roots. Whenever there is very little water in the soil, no, it will be very deep in the underground area. So these shrubs have long roots or deep roots which can penetrate till the groundwater level, and they will use that water and they will grow into a shrub. So the second adaptation what we have studied in desert plants is about the desert shrubs. These desert shrubs have very deep roots, long roots, which can reach underground area, and they suck the water from that underground water table. Okay, that's why they are able to grow throughout the year. Clear? So this is the second adaptation. What have we studied in the first adaptation? We have studied that they conserve water. Desert plants can save water in their succulent parts, and that's how they live or survive in the desert region throughout the year. The second adaptation is adaptation in desert shrubs, which have deep roots. Because they have deep roots, they can reach underground water level and they use that water and they grow. This is second adaptation. What is third adaptation? Third adaptation is the adaptation present in desert lily. Can you see a flower? So this is the desert lily. The third adaptation is about the adaptation of this plant called as desert lily. What is that adaptation? They are dormant. What is dormancy? Dormant means at some conditions they will not be active at all. Active in the sense they will not grow, they will not eat, they will do nothing. At the same time they will not die also. They will just keep mum. They do not do any activity, but still they will be alive. That is called dormant stage. What is given during the dry seasons? Which is a dry season? The season whenever there is no rainfall, when there is no water available for this desert lily plant, it will just keep dormant. It will not grow at all. It will just stay alive during dry seasons. Whenever water is available, what this plant will do? It will grow very fast. Whenever there is rainfall, the plant will grow very fast. And whenever the season is very dry, when there is no rainfall, the plant will just keep idle, or it will remain dormant. Dormancy is the correct word. Okay, so it remains dormant. This is the third adaptation. So what adaptations we have seen? First adaptation, desert plants conserve water in their succulent parts. Second adaptation, desert shrubs have deep roots which will take the underground water, and that is the second adaptation. And the third adaptation is about desert lily plants. They keep dormant during the dry seasons and then they grow very fast whenever water is available. And one more adaptation is given in your textbook, the fourth adaptation. Can you see something rolling? It is actually called tumble. When something rolls, no, the word is called tumble. This plant itself is called tumbleweed. It is a desert weed. So what it does, it rolls about on the desert. They are blown by the winds. Why it is rolling? They are carried away by the winds. Deserts are usually windy regions, right? So they are carried away by the winds and they roll on the flat surfaces. See, this is not a hill or something. It is just a flat surface. They can be rolling fast in a flat surface because of the winds. So where do they go and reach? They reach very far. And why they are doing this rolling activity? Because of this rolling, what is the advantage? The seeds can spread from this area to another area. When the tumbleweed rolls, the seeds are scattered to that area and the new plants can be grown up in the other part of the deserts also. Clear? This is the adaptation of tumbleweeds. So the one which is tumbling or rolling about is called the tumbleweed. It is easily blown away by the winds and it is blown only on flat surfaces mostly. And why it happens? Because it is taken off to a very far off region and the seeds of this weed is spread to other areas of the desert also. So this is the fourth adaptation of desert plants. What are the four adaptations we have studied about desert plants? Number one, desert plants conserve water in their succulent parts. And then number two, about the desert shrubs, which are what they do, they have deep roots which will take underground water. And the third adaptation is desert lily. What they do, they remain dormant whenever the season is dry and they become actively growing during the water availability time. And the fourth one is about the tumbleweeds. What they do, they are blown away by the wind on flat surfaces and they spread their seeds easily. The growth of the plants are promoted. So these are the four adaptations given in your textbook. The next topic, a small topic is given in your textbook. It is about the adaptation of cactus plants. You know that cactus is the most dominant or frequently you can see cactus in the deserts, right? The prominent one what we can see in a desert is cactus plants. So there are three adaptations given about the cactus plants in your textbook. We will quickly see about those adaptations also. So the adaptations in cacti. What is cacti and what is cactus? Cactus is singular. What is singular? One. If only there is one cactus plant, it is called cactus. And what is cacti? Cacti is plural. If there are many cactus plants, you have to use the word cacti. Okay. So what are the, there are three adaptations I told you, no? Since this plant is the most common desert plant, it is specially explained. Okay. So the first adaptation in a cactus plant is, see, this is a cactus plant. The leaves are modified. Where is the leaf here? So usually what we understand is this is the leaf, right? This is not the leaf, this is the stem. Which is the leaf? Can you see a thorn like structure? There are many thorns, right? These are the leaves of cactus plant. The thorns are the leaves. The one which pricks you, know, when you try to hold the plant, something is pricking you, know, that is the leaves. The leaves in cactus plants are modified. What is modification? Modification means usually houses all we modify, right? Houses or dresses. Modification means the existing one is changed. Usually leaves are of this shape, right? This is the shape of a leaf. But here, can you find this shape? No, it is modified into thorns because to withstand the extreme conditions, the leaves are modified into what are they modified? They are modified into spines. What is the spine? I told you thorns, no? The technical word of the thorn is spine. So what is this called? It is called as spines, which are nothing but leaves of the cactus plants. So this is not the leaf, this is the stem. The spines are the leaves of the cactus plants. Why instead of a leaf, spines are found in cactus plants? It is an adaptation of the desert plants. Because of this modification only, the plants are able to survive in a desert without water availability. How? Because this modification conserves water or preserves water or stores water because it prevents transpiration. What is transpiration? Loss of water through the leaves. Now, the spines are very thick. Though it is a leaf, spines are the leaves, I told you, no? So though it is a leaf, it is very thick so that the water is not escaped. What is transpiration? Loss of water through the leaves, no? So when there are no leaves, there are spines, there is no water loss. Already desert doesn't have much water, right? So because of this modification, the water is conserved so much. This is the first adaptation in desert plants. So what did I tell you? You cannot find leaves in the desert cacti because it is modified into a structure called as spine. This spine is useful in conserving or preserving water to the plant because transpiration doesn't happen through spines. So this is the first adaptation in a cactus plant. The second adaptation is the stem. I told you this is the stem. This is not the leaf. This is the stem. Which is the stem? The green color region, what you find here is the stem. Though it appears like a leaf, it is the stem of the cactus. So the second adaptation is about the stem. How it is adapted? It is green. Can you find the stem? Usually what is the color of the stem? The color of the stem is brown in color. No, mostly it is not green all, but in cactus you can find green stems. So whenever something is green, it means there is chlorophyll pigments which can undergo photosynthesis, which will provide food for the cactus plant, and they are thick and fleshy. If you find a cactus plant, just try to break, you can find water oozing out, and also it is fleshy. You can find some fleshy part inside this stem, so it doesn't dry that easily. The water and also the fleshy part will help the cactus plant prevent from drying. And as I told you, since it is green in color, also the food for the plant is also carried out by the stem, and also it is a storehouse of water. Stem is the place where it holds on. Whenever water is available, it will hold the water. So what is the adaptation of stem in a cactus plant? The stem, usually they are green because chlorophyll is present, photosynthesis happens. They are very thick and fleshy, and because they are thick and fleshy, they can store water whenever water is available. So this is the second adaptation of cactus plants. And the last adaptation of cacti are the waxy nature. Can you see the plant? This is a closer view of the cactus plant. You can see a shiny surface, no? Usually the apples what we get these days in the markets, no? It has some waxy coating which makes it so shiny. Have you seen some variety? Not all the varieties, country breeds all, they are not so shiny. But some varieties of apples are coated with wax and they are so shiny to look upon because of the wax, right? So similarly, the cactus plant itself, nobody is going to coat it with apples all, we coat, right? Artificially it is coated with wax, but cactus plants by nature have such a waxy coating which is so shiny. And what is the advantage of this waxy coating? This coating will prevent the loss of water. The water from inside will not go out because of this waxy coating. So that's why the stem will hold the water for many years to together. So this waxy coating is the third adaptation in a cactus plants. So these are the three adaptations of cactus plants. So that is all for today's class. For your homework, please read page number 108 and 109 in your biology textbook. So when I tell read, read carefully, read word by word, and keep updated yourself so that it is easy for you during your class test. So keep reading. That is all for today's biology class. Until I meet you in your next zoology class tomorrow, you all take care and bye bye.